For this treatment, we're going to apply three beams, a right post oblique, another right post oblique, and a right anterior oblique. The beams have come in through the right lung so that we can reduce the dose to the overall combined lung. The only dose that the left lung will therefore receive is exit dose. The right post oblique that's not far from a posterior field has been angled slightly so we can avoid the spinal cord. As you can see here, these yellow lines and these blue lines, these represent the MLCs. These are 1 centimetre thick leaves that you can push into the field to shield out certain areas. As you can see, the PTV here is a specific shape. If we applied this field only without any shielding, we would be treating this normal tissue here. Also, we can see that the spinal cord is very close to that field, so by applying these MLCs here, we can make sure that the spinal cord doesn't receive full dose from that field. So now we need to calculate the dose distribution and normalise the plan to the isocentre. So the isodose lines all represent different percentages of the dose according to their colour. This pale pink colour here, that represents 30% of the dose, but this cerise pink colour here represents 100% of the dose. If we move it up into a big screen, it's easier to visualise. This cyan colour, this is representing 95% of the dose. This is what the doctor has asked the PTV to be covered by. From here, the planner needs to review the doses to the normal surrounding tissue. We need to ensure that high doses aren't received by normal tissue unnecessarily. There are generally two hotspots in a three-field plan, i.e. where the three fields intersect, and these are this area here and this area here. We applied wedges to these beams, and these helped us push the dose from this hot area here over to this cold area here. The doses to the left lung is also reduced, and only 30% is received in the pericardium and mediastinum. As we scroll through the distribution, we can see that we've got an homogeneous dose distribution, and we achieve that by applying a wedge in the superior and inferior direction. So we can see there that 95% is covered, and also here this information tells us that 95% is the minimum for the PTV. We also have a mean for the PTV of 99.9%, and we have a maximum of 102.5. All these percentages are within the ICRU recommendations, which state that the maximum dose must be no more than 107% and the minimum dose must be no less than 95%.